the wheel. Upon its turning depended the dreams of men. Each turning of the wheel on its hub meant a few hard-earned feet of new land conquered by a determined flow of settlers from the east. The wheels of a Conestoga wagon carried people, young people, old people, all kinds of people, but people with strength, with dreams, people in search of homes and a bit of land. People and wheels, the wheels increasing in speed, people increasing in numbers, whirling wheels, industrial wheels, speeding, turning, on land and on water. People and wheels coming to rest finally on the banks of the white foaming waters, as the Indians called the Ohio River. Settlers borrowed an Indian word and called their settlement wheeling. History records many tribulations in wheeling. The Battle of Fort Henry in 1782. Another, McCulloch's famous leap as the Major escaped the red men. Little by little, the battle for survival was won. The wheels were doing their work and a promising city of Wheeling took shape. In 1850, the old market was a busy place. And so was Main Street with its traffic jam. An important spoke in the wheel became known as the National Road. Still another, the majestic Ohio with its boats stopping at Wheeling. Many wheels and hard-working people, a combination that combined to build this, Wheeling, as we know it today. From this industrial hub, the spokes reach out in all directions, on the land, on the water, and in the air. There was a time when increased traffic, east and west, welcomed the historic suspension bridge. More wheels and still more demanded a newer bridge, and so Wheeling built the Fort Henry Bridge, named for the spot where our forefathers stood their ground against attack. The heart of a retail trading area of 500,000 persons, Wheeling, West Virginia. The business district throbs with people, the attractive well-stocked stores downtown attracting crowds every day. The Ohio County Library, its shelves are the storehouses of learning. Wheeling hospitals, too, move constantly forward. At the Ohio Valley General Hospital, a multi-million dollar expansion program has been completed. Wheeling Hospital is also expanding. The city is the medical hub of the upper Ohio River Valley. Signs of progress continue to take form. The ultra-modern wharf parking garage on the banks of the Ohio. Life in the 20th century is being served. A forward-looking government under the city manager system has built itself a new workshop. Here in the new modern city-county building, the municipal problems of tomorrow are taken care of today. As the center of the upper Ohio Valley, Wheeling means industry. At its nearby sprawling Steubenville Works, the Wheeling Steel Corporation makes raw metal for a half dozen of its processing and fabricating plants, all located within a radius of 20 miles. Within a stone's throw of Wheeling Steel's Steubenville plant, is another metal-making giant, the Weirton Steel Company, division of National Steel Corporation. After the molten metal has been produced in the blast furnaces, it is processed in still other furnaces. Expert handling by the skilled steel workers results in finished products of high quality. Pipe goes into railroad cars, into trucks, and into river barges. This pipe will move out of the valley to the far corners of the United States and the world. Among the finished products made of steel are coal buckets, tin plate for construction, appliances, cars, or toys. Wheeling has diversified industry, not the least of which is tobacco and tobacco products. From the drying machines in the Block Brothers Company comes raw tobacco to be shredded. It is then put into packages bearing the famous mayo pouch label. Block Brothers does not stop there in its tobacco products. From its processing plant comes well-known Kentucky Club pipe tobacco. Thousands of the aromatic packages roll off the production line to the loading docks every day. And what man hasn't bitten off the end of a famous Marsh Wheeling stogie? Here in its Wheeling plant, M. Marsh & Son Company uses the most modern equipment to turn out some of the best smoking pleasure in the country. Daily, thousands of boxes of Marsh Wheeling stogies are dispatched to all parts of the United States. Wheeling's tobacco-making industry has preserved a bit of the past. The art of rolling a leaf into a good smoke. The J.F. Miller Company makes and sells a good product with an ageless merchandising twist, the hand-rolled stogie. Wheeling, once labeled the Stogie City, clings tenaciously and traditionally to that title. Wheeling Stamping Company also combines the old and the new. Lead slugs stamped out and moved along a conveyor belt will soon become toothpaste tubes. The lead slugs are drawn out, extruded to form the tube. And into the tubes will go some of the most famous brands of toothpastes in the nation. Wheeling Stamping's progressiveness is illustrated by the fact that it has joined in the plastics parade, turning out bottle caps made of the miracle substance. The Valley's first industry was glassmaking. Today, at Continental Can's Hazel Atlas division, many new shapes of glasses and bottles are manufactured, conceived first in the drawing room. From the drawing board to the plastic model, then to the finished bottle. Hazel Atlas bottles and jars are used as containers for many of the nation's most famous brands. Unlike the pottery kilns in other nearby sections of the Ohio Valley, the skilled hands and lungs of the master craftsmen fashion the finest in glass. Delicate, beautiful, fine glass dinner and decorative ware is a part of the Wheeling area scene. Candlewick from the Imperial Glass Company plant in nearby Bel Air, Ohio. Tasteful, fashionable dinnerware by the Fostoria Glass Company of Moundsville, West Virginia. Using only a blowing tube and a shaping tool, these skilled glass blowers can take a glowing lump of the liquefied raw material and by blowing, whirling, spinning, form a plate, a drinking glass, or a decorative piece. Beautiful colored creations by Imperial, lovely etched tableware from Fostoria. These are found on tastefully planned dinner tables throughout the world. Coal for the furnaces of the nation, dwarfing the Ohio hillsides into which it eats its way in 90-ton bites, is the Hanna Coal Company's gargantuan power shovel, the Mountaineer. It removes the overburden and lays open the rich seams of coal for smaller units. which will scoop up and load the coal for shipment. Other area coal producers are the Powhatan Mining Division of the North American Coal Corporation and the Valley Camp Coal Company, acknowledged leaders in the industry, as is Hanna's parent firm, the Consolidated Coal Company. At Hanna's new Ireland Deep Mine, south of Wheeling, the miners go far into the earth, where they mine thousands of tons of coal each day. This coal travels up a mile-long conveyor belt to the preparation plant. There it is washed, screened, processed. It is then moved by a continuous conveyor belt to another new industrial facility, the Cammer Power Plant. Jointly owned by the Ohio Power Company and the aluminum-making Ormet Corporation is the Cammer plant, which supplies the power needed to turn raw bauxite into the aluminum made and processed in the nearby Ormet Olin Matheson plant. American Electric Power Corporation, Ohio Edison, Ohio Power, and Wheeling Electric, another spoke in the area's economy. One of the area's most vital commodities, natural gas. From the gas wells nearby will come fuel to help maintain the high rate of production by area plants. Manufacturers Light and Heat serves residential, commercial, and industrial users around the hub city. The Majorsville compressor plant, feeding one of Manufacturers 12 storage pools, and such underground summer storage assures a plentiful supply for all wintertime needs. A giant new addition to the Wheeling area's industrial scene, the sprawling, spanking new aluminum plant of the Ormet Corporation. Raw ores are turned into ingots, rolled into sheets, and readied for fabricators. Chemicals are extracted from the inexhaustible supply of salt brine in the pockets of the earth, a rich resource of the area. Turning out chemicals are such well-known names as National Aniline and Solvay, divisions of the Allied Chemical Corporation, the Columbia Southern Chemical Corporation of Pittsburgh Plate Glass, Monsanto's Mobay Chemical Company. From this part of the upper Ohio River comes chemicals with such fancy names as chlorides, urethanes, polyesters, and many others. The basic ingredients created here are the wonder materials of today and tomorrow. The Ohio River is synonymous with the chemical industry. Coal must be moved, and steel must be moved, and glass and chemicals moved out from the hub into every corner of the nation. Fine railroads in the valley help do the job, the Baltimore and Ohio, and the Pennsylvania. Other wheels turn in the Wheeling area. A truck is loaded with pipe at a steel mill, rolls westward to Chicago. In the unlikely combination of trucks and railroad flat cars, piggyback hauling has carved its niche in the transportation scene. The Ohio River claims a major share of the transportation business flowing through the hub. Riverboats push coal north from the valley mines, then return with finished products on the downstream trip. More tonnage by boats and barges is hauled every year past Wheeling than is hauled annually through the St. Lawrence Seaway or the Panama Canal. A transportation artery so valuable as the Ohio River must be cared for and improved. A series of new high-level locks and dams are constantly under construction. This one is between New Cumberland, West Virginia, and Stratton, Ohio. capable of handling even the largest tows in their 1,200-foot locks, these new dams will enable the boats to be locked through without having to be broken into sections. The high-level locks and dams will also provide 30-mile-long, 12-foot-deep pools of unbroken waterway. There must also be facilities to transport people. The ultra-modern Ohio County Airport is served by major airlines, linking Wheeling with other major cities throughout the nation. A fleet of private planes also stands ready for charter at the airport, and plane servicing facilities are operated by the skilled hands of airplane and engine mechanics. People and wheels. For those who prefer to travel overland, there's the Baltimore and Ohio Railroad. And the terminal where famous name bus lines make many arrivals and departures every day. Another phase of the widespread transportation network which crisscrosses the hub. In the field of communications, Wheeling stands ready. Newspapers, radio and television stations all have found the economic life within the wheel rich and abundant. Modern high-speed newspaper presses, capable of printing four color pictures and advertisements on one run, are a vital segment of this communications picture. From the editorial offices, composing room, and press room of the news publishing company comes news and features to keep people well informed. Morning editions of the Intelligencer and afternoon editions of the News Register keep area folks informed of the turning wheel of progress. The Times Leader is published, printed, and delivered to Eastern Ohio residents. At least seven radio stations in the area fill another important role in the network of entertaining and communications. Wheeling is the home of radio station WWBA's famed World's Original Jamboree. Jamboree performers entertain folks not only in all parts of this country, but in Canada and even in the Arctic Circle. The fantastic run of this popular show has virtually spanned the history of the radio industry over the past quarter century. The area boasts two TV stations. From WTRF-TV's transmission tower comes sound and picture to serve television homes. In its studios downtown Wheeling, WTRF-TV combines the latest equipment, production techniques, and skilled camera work. Local programming supplements the station's affiliation with the National Broadcasting Company network. Communication by highway. Modern high-speed highways to carry commerce and cars, to carry traffic from all points of the compass across the hub, people and wheels. Approaching Wheeling from the south along the Ohio side of the river, motorists travel a four-lane divided highway, giving a panoramic view of the Wheeling skyline. From the west, the motorist enters the city over the wide new Fort Henry Bridge, arches and traffic lanes designed to handle tomorrow's traffic. The eastern approach to Wheeling is over the historic Old National Road. Today, it is a modern traffic artery known as U.S. Route 40. From the hub into the rolling countryside, one travels on good roads, good for today's traffic. But what of tomorrow? Mammoth earth movers and construction equipment give the answer. A six-lane divided highway built to interstate specifications and designated as Interstate Route 70, carved through the heart of Wheeling as the old gives way to the new. carryalls and concrete. Interstate work is going on in Belmont County, Ohio, as Interstate Route 70 is being pushed toward Columbus. Within the 1960s, Wheeling will be linked with the capital city of Ohio by an unbroken 130-mile stretch of smooth, divided highway. Much remains to be done. Twin tunnels through Wheeling Hill. The project stands ready to be accomplished. Plans are drawn, and an interchange model has been constructed. When complete, wheels and people will move over a maze of ramps, overpasses, and underpasses at the tunnel's western entrance. But what of its young people, the scholars, businessmen, scientists, and government leaders of the future? Wheeling is synonymous with education and educational facilities. It starts with the very young, their games, their associations, their kindergarten graduations. It is a city of schools, modern, up-to-date educational institutions for grade school and high school students, for those seeking higher learning. Wheeling abounds in schools, private as well as public. Lindsley Institute, where youthful cadets of grade and high school age respond sharply to drill and marching commands. More important, they learn discipline and obedience as part of the curriculum. Nearby is Mount DeChantel Academy, a private finishing school. Here the girls find scholastic emphasis not only on the three R's, but on music, dramatics, and the arts as well, all in a campus setting. The annual May procession and crowning of the Queen are but a part of the extracurricular activities. Wheeling and its immediate area are rich in institutions of higher learning. It is the home of stately, scholarly Bethany College, the classic architecture of its buildings blending into a tree-shaded campus. Steeped in the early history of the United States, Bethany is also the home of Alexander Campbell, educator and founder, not only of Bethany College, but of the Christian Church. West Liberty State College is located high on a clean, fresh hilltop, just 20 minutes from downtown Wheeling. West Liberty turns out teachers, educators, businessmen, scientists, and dental technicians. These are the ultra-modern structures of Wheeling College, operated by the Jesuit fathers. The college, emphasizing the sciences, saw its first graduating class in 1959. Because of its makeup, with its legion of nationalities, Wheeling has opened its arms to the many religions. A deeply religious people, the churchgoers often boast of more churches per capita than any other city of its size in the United States. Wheeling has made welcome the Baptist and Presbyterian, Episcopalian and Methodist, Lutheran, Catholic, and Jew, so that all could build their houses of worship and fill them with reverent people. Wheeling is the home of famed Ogilvy Park and handsome Wilson Lodge. Ogilvy, the nation's model municipal park, is just a part of the pleasure-giving facilities with which Wheeling is blessed. This beautiful park is the fulfillment of a dream, the dream of men who wanted the fuller life for all the people who live in the valley. Ogilvy Park has been accurately described as a country club for everyone. Located on 1,000 acres of rolling, tailored landscape, high in the hills, Ogilvy boasts some of the most beautiful scenery to be found in the United States. The Mansion Museum, former home of the late Colonel Earl W. Ogilvy, who willed his Waddington farm to the city for a park. Wheeling Park Superintendent Homer Fish, the man primarily responsible for turning the farm into this outstanding park, aided by an experienced, qualified staff. One of the centers of activity during summertime at Ogilvy is the beautiful Crispin Center swimming pool, landscaped into the surrounding countryside. On the waters of nearby Schenck Lake, boaters enjoy scenic Ogilvy. While in the waters, thousands of rainbow trout, a challenge for area fishermen. Ogilvy belongs to people of all ages. The playground is a popular spot. The park offers 6 tennis courts and a tennis clubhouse. Horseback riding along one of the 14 miles of wooded bridle trails, a never-to-be-forgotten experience. There are sport camps, caddy camps, day camps, and nature camps at Ogilvy Park. Under the guidance of a full-time naturalist, youngsters get on-the-spot instruction. Camp Russell is one of two specially designed youth camps. Training is given in folk dancing, baton twirling, and 4-H work. Opera workshops and YMCA camps are also a part of the Camp Russell agenda. In Ogilvy's outdoor amphitheater, residents are treated to music under the stars by the Wheeling Symphony Orchestra. Name bands and entertainers appear regularly under the sponsorship of Ogilvy Institute. At its sister park, Wheeling, thousands of people enjoy concerts on the spacious tree-shaded lawn. Like Ogilvy, Wheeling Park is a complete recreational unit with a lake, playground, swimming pool, golf course, and artificial ice skating rink. Wheeling Country Club, with its well-maintained golf course, clubhouse, and swimming pool, another phase of the ever-improving recreational scene. When snow blankets the countryside surrounding the city, Ogilvy Park becomes a storyland of winter beauty and sports. Winterized cabins with big open stone fireplaces assure guests of the ultimate in comfort. The snow-covered slopes of Ogilvy and a ski tow get plenty of action. Skiers, sled riders, and tobogganers take part in a full program of winter sports. On the frozen surface of the 3-acre Schenck Memorial Lake, hundreds of ice skaters find their pleasure on the singing blades. For those who prefer the sport of kings, there is beautiful Wheeling Downs. This half-mile track is located only a few minutes from the heart of Wheeling's business district on the southern tip of Wheeling Island. Racing fans come here from 3 states. The track's handsome clubhouse and grandstand, and its landscaped, flower-bedecked grounds, have earned it the title of America's most beautiful half-mile track. The Ohio Valley Yacht Club, on the banks of the Ohio River, offers the people of the Wheeling area many pleasures. There is, of course, boating, water sports of all kind, and all-star aquatic shows. Something is available almost daily during the warm season. The annual regatta and boat races are an especially popular attraction. The river is without a doubt coming of age as another playground. As it has been in the past, the Ohio River remains a vital lifeline to the industrial growth of busy, progressive Wheeling, West Virginia, home of skilled hands fashioning the better life, bustling hub of business and industry, glass, tobacco, chemicals, power, steel, aluminum, coal. Daily, the mountains are being carved into molehills by machinery, building new spokes for its economy. The wheel turns ever faster on modern high-speed highways or on the ageless river. Happy faces at work and play, reverent ones at worship, young interested ones at learning, a city marching together in community spirit. The wheel has turned and Wheeling has gone forward. Its spokes have become the muscles of prosperity. It is, in the finest sense of the word, a jewel-studded hub on the Ohio for the wheels to progress.